Would the president turn back? No way. He began to undress. So did the others. They piled their clothes on the riverbank. Then, one by one, they jumped into the water and swam for the other side. This may have been a strange way to act, but not for Theodore Roosevelt. He was the 26th president of the United States, and almost everything about him was unusual. President Roosevelt, or Teddy, was full of energy. He didn't just hike. He boxed, wrestled, played tennis, and rode horses. Teddy liked to keep busy, and he liked to get things done. Once he set a goal, he wouldn't let anything stand in his way. That's why he liked his point-to-point walks. He set out from one point and went straight to another point. He didn't let anything force him off his path, not even the Potomac River. Good timing. Teddy became president in 1901. He was the perfect man for the job. A new kind of president for a new century. He wanted to push the country in a different direction. Times were changing. The U.S. continued to grow. Settlers kept moving farther west. The country's leaders worried about the problems inside the U.S. The nation stayed out of world events. Teddy wanted the U.S. to be a world leader. He wanted to set big, important goals. Then he wanted the country to march towards its goals, no matter what. He saw the future of the country as if it were a giant point-to-point hike, and he was the man to lead. How did Teddy get to be the way he was? Why did he make the choices he made? To find the answers, you have to go back to the time when Teddy was just beginning his life. Left. Teddy chopped down trees and cleared land for exercise. Right. Heading west. As the U.S. grew, many people loaded up wagons and headed west. In 1800, there were 16 states. By 1900, there were 45.